Good evening. I am Double H here with my friend Tara Armoff.
Hello.
And we are getting ready for a battle royale this evening, a rematch from Salt Lake City, which you and I attended.
That's right. This is a rematch, or a redo, as it were, of the third place game from Salt Lake City playoffs last year between Rocky Mountain, who moved on from that game and made it to championships, up against Charm City.
So, of course, you're watching the 2015 Division One playoffs live from Tucson, Arizona for the Women's Flatjack Derby Association, and it's brought to you by the WFTDA and Tucson Roller Derby. Charm City is now number 19th in the WFTDA. They come in the number 5 seed to this tournament, and Rocky Mountain seed number 4 in this tournament, coming in at rank number 14 right now in the WFTDA. So, taking a look at Charm City's roster, we have 1001 Colleen Best, 127 Nikki Cash, NC17 Cherry Licious, 178 Raven Darkhold, T2 Ally Be Back, 2873 She Bear, 308 Gigi Hardy, 34 Lady Kaboom, number 41 Scariot Tubman, number 415 Holly Go Hardly, number 514 Dottie Deathwish, number 6 Hitsburg, number 8 Free Radical, number 91 Loretta Scars.
And on the Rocky Mountain side, we have number 12 Bones Patrol, 13 Jersey Whirl, 1896 Tootsie Roller, 22 Phantom Menace, 31 Fiona Grapple, 33 Sharon Tacos, 37 Blah Blah Blah, 422 Gagan, 55 Susie Pow, 7423 Triple Shot Misto, the team captain, 86 Salt and Peppa, 949 Wile E. Coyote, 99 Make You Pay, and M80 Sweet Mary Payne.
So Rocky Mountain's record this year is 3-6. They've posted losses to Rose City, Gotham, Denver, Texas, Angel City and London. In Pack Destruction, they did not come away with a win. And on the Charm City side, we have a record of 3-6. And losses to Ohio, Boston, Minnesota, Stockholm, Montreal, and Philly. And those last three were at ECDX. So, again, the classic rematch from Salt Lake City. We saw both of these teams last year at Salt Lake City. The thing that I remarked about Charm City in Salt Lake City is that their offense was very man-to-man, person-to-person, woman-to-woman, as we should say. And similar things from Rocky Mountain, because we have some very storied skaters on the Rocky Mountain roster, and they are very good one-on-one. So those are the types of things that I'm interested in seeing what their teamwork looks like, especially after Charm's roster looks very different.
Definitely taking a hit on the Jammer side, and they have a transfer, Susie Pow.
Do they?
What?
I had no idea.
Yes, everyone's talking about Susie Pow transferring from Charm City to Rocky Mountain, so this will be very, very interesting. And if you're just tuning in, Charm City is in the yellow, Rocky Mountain in the black.
So lining up on the Fast Girl start line, number 127, Kamikaze Cash for Charm City, and that's M80, Sweet Mary Payne. For Rocky Mountain, looking for an inside line. She pushes her way through to find it. Lead Jammer status, first blood for Rocky Mountain. And also right behind her, about a half a track, is Kamikaze Cash. And that is Charm City taking the front line, calling it off. And that's going to be a 2-point gain for Rocky Mountain. 2 points for Rocky. Charm, nothing yet.
Well, it's only one jam.
That's why I said yes.
It's okay. They'll get there. Lining up on the Fast Girl Skates starter line is number 22, Phantom Menace, going up against number 514, Dottie Deathwish.
Rocky takes the back line. Pushing through up front is Phantom Menace. Getting recycled back is Dottie. Pushing through, that is a 3-brace up front. And Phantom Menace pushes.
And look, you see the jersey pulling as Charm is trying to hold together their polygonal moving wall. Now they're beginning to bridge out. Phantom Menace does get out and get lead.
And that's what these teams are really working to do, is to figure each other out and see which formation is going to work. Phantom Menace coming in for a strike, gets the back of the pack and forced out, drawn back. Very slow start here for both teams. Phantom Menace trying to push through the pack, has one to beat up front, and Scariot Tubman and gets past. That's a 5-point pass for Rocky Mountain.
Dottie Deathwish is sitting in the Derby Supply penalty box right now, so this is a power jam in favor of Rocky Mountain.
Finding the inside and Scariot Tubman again, Phantom Menace calls it for 4 points. So nothing yet for Charm City and 11 for Rocky Mountain.
And it is going to start in a power jam advantage for Rocky Mountain, and they are throwing out Susie Powell.
Very controversial, Tara Armoff. This is hashtag feelings jam.
That's right. If you have questions, comments, whatnot for the broadcast, and you are on the Twitters, hashtag talk2WFTDA or hashtag WFTDA playoffs. And Susie Powell taking that inside line right out of turn one, getting lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Nice bookend offense on that play from Rocky as Susie hits the back of the pack, getting a little bit of offense on the inside, can't quite take it, looking for some on the out. Nice reformation at the front from Charm City with that box, as VRDL calls it. And out of the box is going to be Dottie Deathwish, who makes it through, gets hit at turn two, forced all the way out of bounds, but that was also an out of play, so that's going to be fine, and she's through for her initial. A little hop to the inside, doesn't pick her up anything, but that's a 5-point gain for Susie Powell. And on the Twitters, we'd love to hear from you. Few feelings right now. Few feelings on Twitter yet, Tara Armoff, but use the hashtag talk2WFTDA.
Well, maybe they would get more feelings if they discovered that the score was Charm City still scoreless, 0 to Rocky Mountain 16 with 26 minutes, 14 seconds in the first half of this game. And we have Sweet Mary Payne up against Holly Gohardley, who jumped out of the pack and did get lead, though Sweet Mary Payne is in the lead.
And she fell to her knees and she shakes her head, disappointed because she did grab lead jammer status.
I want to say thanks to Adam Wheels, Train Hard, Play Smart, Skate Adam, adamskates.com on the internets.
So we are moving into Jam 5, and Charm City still scoreless. Rocky Mountain 16, 25 minutes and 30 some odd seconds.
The pack is set up about 10 feet ahead of the Fast Girl Skates starter line.
That's Sharon Tacos taking on Kamikaze Cash. Brace at the front from Rocky Mountain. It's a three-person brace, and right around the outside, Kamikaze Cash, lead jammer for Charm City. Here's their opportunity to score some points.
Sharon Tacos takes a hop along the outside, making it out of the pack on her initial pass as well.
Coming up against that three wall, getting forced to the outside, darts to the in and calls it. And she will pick up 4 points for Rocky, but one goes up for Charm.
Charm finally breaking the points drought by one whole point to Rocky Mountain's 20, 24 minutes, 51 seconds in the first half. And make sure you don't miss a minute of the action by purchasing your WFTDA watch pass, because this is exciting roller derby action. Only $15 per tournament, or a purchase of the D1 and championship bundle is $60. $60! What a great deal. Live it or stream it live on WFTDA TV.
And Dottie Deathwish right through the inside to become lead jammer, leaving Phantom Menace behind. She's about half a lap behind. Coming in for her scoring run is Dottie Deathwish. On the inside, failed apex jump, and she calls it. There aren't going to be any points on that, or will there? There are two. Okay. My mistake. 2 points for Charm. All right. So Charm City 3, Rocky Mountain 20.
And we have a couple of the Charm blockers in the Derby Supply penalty box. And so it's going to be interesting to see what they can do up against Sweet Mary Payne, who is on the Fast Girl Skates starter line. And Rocky Mountain lining up in a four wall against that starter line. Going up against Kamikaze Cash.
Sweet Mary Payne gets forced out on the inside at the front, but is able to jump back in time to become lead jammer. Recycled all the way back, Kamikaze Cash coming in. Sweet Mary Payne to the front. She's got two to beat. Gets a little tiny help in there from Assault and Peppa, or as Ringster calls her, Assault Peppa. Oh, cutting penalty being assessed now to Kamikaze Cash. This is a power jam for Rocky Mountain.
Sweet Mary Payne resetting in the back of the pack, taking that inside line, gets through completely untouched. That's five more points for Rocky Mountain.
Setting up at the front, Charm City with the box. They are braced. Nice little offensive hit in the middle there, breaking apart the pack. Phantom Menace finds those holes, comes right up against Cherrylicious.
Really nice recycling by Cherrylicious on that pass, trying to stop Sweet Mary Payne. But she does get through for her 5 points, and Kamikaze Cash is out of the Derby Supply penalty box.
Forced to the inside there. Nice three wall from Charm City. Nice job threading the needle there from Sweet Mary Payne as she comes up against that brace. And a cutting call being assessed to Kamikaze Cash back to the Derby Supply penalty box. Coming up against a two wall up at the front, Sweet Mary Payne. They're forced to let her go. She's straddling the line, and she looks like she thought for a minute, what do I do? And she made the right decision.
Yeah, she can afford to play it safe. Charm City with 3 points, Rocky Mountain at 40. And there's 21 minutes, 46 seconds left in the first half of this game. So Rocky Mountain on their way to taking a commanding lead. And penalty-wise, only two people have gotten penalties on the Rocky Mountain side, and that's one each. And we have more than two people on the Charm City side. They're making copious use of the penalty box in this game so far.
And yet again, starting with the power jam for her team is Susie Powell for Rocky Mountain.
Interesting that every time they have a power jam start, they decide to use the old Charm team member there. Kamikaze Cash back on the track.
And we do have revolving penalties. Through for lead jammer, though, is Susie Powell. She takes a quick look behind her to assess the situation and getting some direction from her bench. Breaking the pack, Kamikaze Cash is behind her about a quarter of a track. Susie turns around and calls it, and that's going to be two more points for Rocky Mountain, giving them 42 to Charm City's 3.
Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots from Bont. Check them out online at bont.com.
Daniel on Twitter says, Tara Armoff and Double H are the dream team, and I bet Tara smells clean too. You guys have no idea how clean Tara Armoff smells. Just an FYI there. This is Dottie Deathwish taking on Sharon Tacos. A delicious treat becomes lead jammer.
This is the sixth jam that Rocky has gotten lead so far in this game.
Coming up against that three brace in the front. Beautiful offensive work there from Rocky Mountain, just sort of pigpiling. And that's 3 points for their team.
And they are holding Charm City to 3 points, Rocky Mountain at 45, 19 minutes, 40 seconds in the first half of this game.
Rocky Mountain's been able to take advantage of 3 power jams so far to their favor. We have Holly Go Hardly, number 415, on the Fast Girl start line against Phantom Menace, number 22 for Rocky Mountain.
Rocky Mountain
going down right away, Phantom Menace.
Rocky Mountain having that back wall against the Fast Girl skates line. Phantom Menace gets out and gets lead.
Getting forced out of bounds. Holly Go Hardly is forced hardly out of bounds, and she is finally through for her initial. Phantom Menace on a point scoring run. Coming up against the likes of Colleen Best, and around tries to grab Allie B back and is able to do so. That's a 4-point pass for Rocky Mountain. And there is some loud vocal expression from Sir Osis, but Tara Armoff, tell us something.
Sir Osis has things to say. I am surprised. S1 helmets are rad. Get rad. Get an S1 helmet at s1helmets.com.
Ah, he was yelling that there is a Charm City timeout. And this is an excellent time, I think, for Charm City to be able to do that. So 18 minutes and 51 seconds left in the first. Charm City only 3 points on the board. Rocky Mountain with 49. This is a very fast-moving game as well. Both of these teams, both of these teams full of skaters are moving a lot faster than I think that I thought that I would see. Certainly, they are utilizing that three-person brace a lot, both of these teams. And again, there's that individual hitting that we've talked about from both of these teams as well.
It seems to me that penalties are the difference. Rocky is able to play this style very cleanly. Charm, maybe not so much. And so it'll be interesting to see if they're able to adjust their style a little bit so that they can maintain control and get their jammers out of the pack.
Yeah, and I think they're still trying to figure out whether the front or the back is actually working better for them.
They are in the front on this go-around, Rocky Mountain walling it up in the back. Wild E Coyote jamming for Rocky Mountain up against Kamikaze Cash.
We'll get it one of these days.
Sometime, like about 3 minutes from the end of the game, I'll figure it out. And now we have a power jam in favor of Rocky Mountain.
That is a forearm sending Kamikaze Cash to the Derby Supply penalty box. Lead jammer status goes to Wild E Coyote, making her way through the inside. Tripping up a little bit, but grabbing 5 points on that pass.
And this is Kamikaze Cash's third penalty so far in this game, and it's still in the first half. So basically, almost every time she's gone out as a jammer, she's gotten a penalty. That's no bueno if you want to score points.
No bueno for scoring points. And so that three brace, trying to stay together, Rocky Mountain just ripping it apart here. It does reform, but in the mix, quite a few folks ripping it up. Now just pushing at the front is Wild E Coyote. It's a nice two-person brace there. Yeah, Scariot Tubman forced to let her go.
Yeah, that's right. Charm City doing the bridging as long as humanly possible, finally having to let Wild E Coyote go.
Big hit out of bounds there on the inside for Kamikaze Cash. That was her little welcome back into the pack from the penalty box.
Welcome back into the game. And she draws a track cut. This is her fourth penalty so far in this game. So we're back to a power jam advantage for Rocky Mountain. Rocky Mountain just racking up the points right now. Oh my goodness.
Huge problem right now for Charm City. They've got three on the track. Rejoining them is Hitzberg from the penalty box. So now they will have four, and calling it off, Wild E Coyote. And the next jam is going to start with a Charm City jammer in the box.
Again. Let's see. Oh, they're breaking the stride. Rocky's breaking the stride. We don't see Susie Powell on the jammer line at the start of this power jam. WFTDA wants to thank 5on5 magazine for supporting all of the wonderful things that WFTDA does. And 5on5 has a booth here and everything. So if you guys are going to show up at the venue this weekend, stop by and say hello.
We do have Sweet Mary Payne jamming for Rocky Mountain. She's through to become lead jammer. Taking the back, waiting for some offensive direction is Rocky. Pushing forward is Assault and Peppa. And reforming at the back while Kamikaze Cash comes out of the penalty box is that nice box at the back from Rocky Mountain. Charm City coming back to help their jammer out. Will it be enough?
She gets through on that inside line. But Rocky's recycling, just phenomenal, getting back in front of her. So we're back to everyone just bunching up along team lines, trying to stop the opposing jammer.
I apologize. That was Make You Pay that I see in the pack, and not Assault and Pepper. And Triple Shot Misto headed to the penalty box. And again, so this is Kamikaze Cash's fifth penalty. And we're only halfway through the first period. So this is big trouble right now for Charm City. Meanwhile, another 5 points on the board for Sweet Mary Payne.
Charm City setting up their pack wall in the front of the pack. And Rocky Mountain goes for the little pads of offense, then goes into assist immediately.
Sweeping the inside, and that is going to be a 5-point pass, says Harry Spotter, for Rocky Mountain. So 90 points now separating these teams, Tara Armoff.
That's right. Charm City still at 3 points. Rocky Mountain at 93 with just under 15 minutes left in the first half of this game. This is not exactly what we expected with the seeding with these teams as close as they are in this tournament.
Agreed, but Susie Pau, as mentioned before, a Power Jam favorite here for Rocky Mountain, getting forced to the outside. She stops herself, straddles, is recycled all the way back, and manages to get through on the inside. She's now tackling two defenders, now three forced to the edge, but not out. And now a three wall of Charm defenders at the front. She's just pushing, getting forced to the inside. She does not get the cutting call. She gets the lead jammer call.
Now we have a star stash from Kamikaze Cash. A very smart move on her part.
And that's going to the pivot free radical, number 8 for Charm City. Susie Powell working on this box at the back, just stops, takes a step back, and then hops forward and is able to break through. And that's a 4-point pass for Susie Powell.
Free radical getting knocked to the outside. She has the jammer cover in her hand.
So this is going to be a penalty, sending Kamikaze Cash to the Derby Supply penalty box. This is 6 for her in this game right now.
Oh dear. At least she's not the jammer. So Charm City does have a chance to score, unless Susie Powell calls it off, which she did.
Making nice use of that ability, she does call it off, and that's a 3-point gain for Susie Powell on that pass.
So I think I lied, because I see people sitting in the Derby Supply penalty box, and that would be Free Radical.
Free Radical.
So apparently that jammer star cover is cursed. That's the only explanation I can think of, because this is, I think, the 7th jammer penalty that Charm has committed just in the first half of this game.
Jamming now is Sharon Tacos. She's lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Charm City setting up a three wall at the front of the pack. Sharon Tacos going up with an assist.
Racing around the outside, that's a 5-point pass for Sharon Tacos. Coming out of the penalty box, Free Radical, still the jammer. She is making her approach at the back, gets forced to the infield. And that was Make You Pay, number 99, with the big hits today.
She's doing an awesome job both on offense and defense in this game. Sharon Taco's getting recycled to the back of the pack. Oh, apparently everyone's getting recycled to the back of the pack. Okay.
Sharon Tacos is sharing some blows at the front of the pack with some Charm City defenders, getting pushed to the front. Around the outside, she grabs 4 points on that pass. And there's a cutting call, and it is going to be Free Radical. So the 3rd penalty for Free Radical, the 2nd for her as a jammer. So that's a box up front from Charm City. Pushing forward is Sharon Tacos, and that's going to be a 4-point pass. She was able to pass them all. Yes, Mary Victoria on Twitter asks, did I hear Kamikaze Cashes on 6 penalties? You did exactly hear that. Talk to WFTDA on Twitter. We can talk more about penalties.
And we can talk. Let's talk about the score. Charm City still at 3 because their jammer has been in the box for the past however many jams now. Rocky Mountain already breaking the century mark with 118 with just under 11 minutes left in the first half of this game.
That's number 22, Phantom Menace, on the inside. Ooh, gets forced in and a forearm call, sending her to the Derby Supply penalty box. This is a stroke of good luck for Charm City.
This is the first power jam in Charm City's favor.
Now standing Free Radical, about to break out of the box and comes up against another kind of box from Rocky Mountain. And there is a star pass. So Holly Go Hardly, number 415 from Charm City, is now wearing the star.
Smart move by Charm City. They want to keep a jammer on the track for a little while. See how that goes.
Finding an inside line, she's able to grab some points. coming to the outside, stays in bounds on one skate. Hard hits from Rocky Mountain. That's a 5-point pass. Charm City, 8 points.
Wow, Phantom Menace back on the track, squeaking by on the outside on one skate.
Holly Gohardley grabs four more, breaking into double digits. Charm City, 12 points. Rocky Mountain, 118. And looking for a little bit of direction from her bench. Holly Gohardley
tries for that apex jump, does not land it, gets recycled back. Phantom Menace taking that outside line, picking up her points.
Holly Gohardley content to play the long game here as she goes through one more time, a 4-point pass for each of these jammers now. I think Holly just wants to get some points up there. Content to play the long game.
She finds her own team at the back of the pack. They let her through and catch Phantom Menace.
Getting forced out on the outside by Fiona Grapple. And that's going to be a whistle, a low block being assessed.
That's on Allie Back. Charm City setting up a three wall at the front. Rocky Mountain. Content to hang back.
Yeah, one additional point on that pass for Rocky. 2 for Charm.
So Charm went scoreless for 8 jams until this particular jam. And WFTDA would like to say thank you to Rink Rash for being supportive.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're awesome.
Dottie Deathwish, number 514 on the Fast Girl start line for Charm City against Sweet Mary Payne, M80 for Rocky.
Who goes down right there on the apex of turn one, hops right back up and gets lead jammer.
Drawn all the way back is Dottie. Gets forced out of bounds on the inside, trying to fight the back. Ooh, through on her toe stops around the outside, is able to make it through for her initial, but that's 5 points to Sweet Mary Payne in front of her. And
Charm trying to kind of race the pack, but Sweet Mary Payne's like, nah, okay, go ahead and do that. She still picks up her points and calls it off.
Everybody got fast for a second.
Just for a second. 18 points for Charm City, 140 for Rocky Mountain with 7 minutes, 35 seconds left in the first half. And want to say thanks to Jackson Skates, more bang for your buck. See the Adam booth. Oh, I'm reading the in-house. But you can check them out online.
All right.
Jackson Skates.
So we've got She Bear, number 2873, taking on Wildy Coyote, 949. Lead jammer is Wildy Coyote.
She Bear stuck at the back on her initial pass, trying to get by Rocky one by one, unsuccessful so far.
And right at the front of the pack, out on her toe stops. Beautiful control there, able to make it out and back in one movement. 5 points for Wildy Coyote. She Bear at the front, spinning around the final two defenders of Rocky Mountain, is able to make it through, and she looks so relieved.
She really I would
does.
Be too.
Me too. She spent a goodly number of seconds in that jam fighting through that pack. Alamo City Roller Girls thought this matchup would be much closer. I think a good number of us also thought it would be much closer.
WFTDA wants to thank Powerdyne. Powerdyne, cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance.
Let us know on Twitter, what do you think? Did you think this matchup would be much closer?
147 points for Rocky Mountain, 18 for Charm City. Susie Powell going up against Holly Gohardley.
Holly Gohardley able to make it to the front portion of the pack, still hanging together very loosely. Popping forward to perform a little bit of offense. That was Allie B. Back, but she gets forced to the inside and recycled, Holly Gohardley does.
A lot of recycling going on. Susie Powell also gets recycled to the back of the pack, a pack hanging out right on the pivot line.
Susie Powell not quite able to make it through. Trying to juke around, is able to do so, stays on her toe stops. Lead jammer status for Rocky Mountain. Now 147 to Charm City's 18. Getting frustrated on the inside line is Holly Gohardley as she's drawn all the way back by Sweet Mary Payne.
That's right, getting set up in the back by Make You Pay.
And she does pass the star, Holly Gohardley does, to pivot Colleen Best.
Oh, big hit, Alibi back, gives to Susie Powell. Susie Powell maintains position, is able to call it off for Rocky Mountain. Charm City frozen at 18 points. Rocky Mountain 156, 4 minutes, 45 seconds left in the first half of this game.
So lead jammer statuses, Rocky Mountain has had 14 of them. Charm City has had 3 of them. So that tells some of this story, Tara.
And penalties are the other story, and we want to give a big thanks to Derby Supply for sponsoring the penalty box this tournament season. All your derby needs at derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
Dottie Deathwish jamming for Charm City against Sharon Tacos for Rocky Mountain. Sharon at the back pushing on the outside to... Nice brace at the back from Charm City. They're able to employ that box quite well. If they can keep it together and keep the pack together, they can do some good work like they just did right there, getting their jammer through. Lead jammer is Dottie Deathwish as she comes in on a scoring run, gets forced to the outside, and gets right back up, not calling it yet.
She's looking for more points, obviously. Wants to try and close that point differential, but she has a three wall of Rocky to contend with. Coming up against Fiona Grapp on blah, blah, blah at the very front. Gets through, picking up some points for Charm City.
So now Charm playing the defense in back with that box. Getting broken up there from Rocky Mountain. Nice job offensively from them trying to open some holes, but both jammers recycled all the way back.
Dottie Deathwish not calling this jam off. This is the first lead jam that Charm has gotten in 12 jams.
And she is able to make it through. And that is a 5-point pass for Dottie Deathwish. Charm City scratching ahead, 27. Rocky Mountain, 156. So coming through, jumping the apex. Dottie Deathwish for 5 points.
Rocky looks a little confused as they before they reconstitute their front wall there. Charm still holding their box wall in the back, sending Sharon Tacos flying into the infield.
And she does have her helmet cover off now. So methinks she's eyeing up the idea of either a stash or just trying to put it back on like she did right there.
Yeah, it looked like she could because Fiona Grapple was within reach to
exactly.
Do a star pass, but maybe not.
And there is an official review being called. We'll take a look and see what that is about in a moment. That's Rocky Mountain calling that official review. Tara Armoff.
Oh, let's see what I can say here. We've been talking about the Fast Girl Start Line, and Fast Girl Skates is sponsoring that Fast Girl Start Line. Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com. Fast Girl Skates, 8 years dedicated to making a faster you. Also want to give a nice shout out to Sin City Skates. They are the on-site skate tech for the Tucson playoff tournament. The first, the best, happy to fix the rest, SinCitySkates.com.
A review of a no-call on a forearm contact by Rocky Mountain's jammer, which knocked a Charm City player to the ground.
So there you go.
Okay. So I did not see that particular instance that OSIS is discussing right now, but we will see what the officials have to say about it. In the meantime, on Twitter, Marissa Berlin says, I don't think anyone thought of one of Charm's jammers would have almost fouled out less than a quarter of the way into the game. I agree. I also think that that is not what folks thought would happen. But, you know, I think that Charm City has definitely had some issues. They've lost in terms of roster. They've lost some jammers, including Susie Powell. And I think that this is kind of a rebuilding process for them where they're going to have to go in and really work on training some jammers.
Apparently so. And especially the penalty count is definitely lopsided against Charm City. And part of that has to do with some of the newness of these new members. So hopefully they'll be able to do some damage control in the rest of this game and see if they can improve the penalties that they get or improve by lowering the number of penalties they get for the rest of the weekend. So again, if you're just tuning in, we have an official review being called by Charm City.
On the track, the Rocky Jammer made contact to illegal blocking zone of the Charm wall. The no call on the floor will stand. Charm City does not retain their official review.
Okay. I also think it's a pretty good, if you're going to take an official review, this is a fairly decent time for them to do it. And you're basically also able to rest your team, right? Like, so that's an opportunity for them to rest their team.
Especially when you have only 2 minutes, 24 seconds on the period clock in this first half.
So wow. She-Bear jamming again for Charm City. Sweet Mary Payne for Rocky. She-Bear really pushing that outside line. And she is going to stumble over a number of Rocky skaters. There's a cutting the track call, and it is not being assessed to her.
Yeah, that goes to one of the Rocky blockers. That is number 99, Makey Pay, on her way to the Derby Supply penalty box. Interesting swarming and recycling by both teams, trying to get those, stop the other jammer while getting their own jammer out. Sweet Mary Payne is the lead jammer. She looks confused as she gets up.
There's a forearm call being levied to Sweet Mary Payne, and she is going to the Derby Supply penalty box, not very happily. She-Bear, getting a little bump on the inside, is able to make it through, and she is not lead, of course, but finally able to make her initial.
Rocky three wall set up. She-Bear hitting that wall.
And now there's going to be a back block call as she does hit the wall. So we will have Sweet Mary Payne back in action.
She gets recycled all the way back to the beginning of turn three as Charm City takes advantage of the bridging.
And hitting that wall, Sweet Mary Payne is able to find the outside. Nice little pop of offense there from the bookends of Rocky Mountain. And back in action also is She-Bear. Pushing that front brace, Sweet Mary Payne is able to make it around on the outside. She-Bear still fighting through, and that's two defenders at the back that she's looking to beat.
It's fun watching the different styles. Sweet Mary Payne is just powering through slowly. She-Bear trying to use her footwork and gets a track cut with that fancy footwork. So she goes back to the Derby Supply penalty box.
So that was a 5-point pass for Rocky Mountain.
And Charm picked up 4 points in that jam as well. So Charm City is up to 37, Rocky Mountain 169, 8 seconds left on the clock, and an official review on the Rocky Mountain side is being called right now.
So we'll see if this is actually a review or if it is being used as guest. Yes, so OSA says that they are using their official review as a timeout, which I think is actually a really good call. Rocky Mountain now 169, Charm City 37.
Did you know the WFTDA is celebrating 10 years of leadership in modern roller derby, and in those 10 years has grown from 20 founding members to more than 400 leagues on 6 continents? Well, you know now.
I know now.
In case you didn't before, and actually you would know that now, but those listening at home, now you know. WFTDA would also like to thank Derby Inc. for their participation in tournament season here at 2015 International Playoffs.
So we're going to...
And actually, there's one more thing.
Yes.
I have not seen this. Tell your family and friends you're busy watching Derby with the WFTDA Do Not Disturb images. Find them at facebook.com/WFTDA. A bunch of you has to put that up so I can see this on my Facebook feed, because this sounds intriguing to me.
Do not disturb, busy watching roller derby.
Very busy, very serious.
Story of my life. That is She-Bear in the penalty box, and right out of the gate, Phantom Menace, number 22, lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Yeah, she got lead jammer, on the apex between turns 1 and 2 as the pack was at a standstill practically.
And the box here for Charm City gets broken up a bit at the front. Phantom Menace able to make enough headway to get past a few defenders. And finally, she's through for the whole five.
She-Bear back on the track, hitting the rocky wall in the back of the pack. She grabs at the jammer cover, gets separated from Cherrylicious the pivot, and she gets recycled back all at the same time.
And right around the outside, Phantom Menace is through for five more points, and this is another jammer penalty. That is a cutting the track penalty for She-Bear, and she is going back to the Derby Supply penalty box.
Phantom Menace maintains her momentum. She gets around the two charm blockers at the front, calls it off. And again, just watching the differences in style, in particular between Phantom Menace and She-Bear. She-Bear trying for that light footwork, and Phantom Menace just staying low, powering through, staying in bounds, picking up those points. Like the opposing blockers are almost literally bouncing off of her. It is amazing. So our halftime score, Charm City 37, Rocky Mountain 184.
So on Twitter, we've got a couple people asking, a lot of jammer discussion. Let's focus on the great work of the blockers. But I do think that in Charm City's case, the inexperience of some of the jammers or some of the blockers being used as jammers is making the line a little bit nervous. So they're breaking away to perform as much offense for them as they can in order to crack them as possible, which is really degrading the integrity of what they're doing and their defense.
Yes, yes. The inexperience and the penalty count is just killing Charm in this game. A little more than some of us have expected, unfortunately.
Well, we're going to have to come back to the second half to find out what happens. I'm Double H here with Tara Armoff. We're going to thank some of our sponsors and come right back for the second half. Welcome back to the 2015 International WFTDA Division I Playoff. Live from Tucson, Arizona. I'm Double H here with Tara Armoff.
Hi, everybody.
I apologize. I was distracted with all of the penalty information that we were reviewing as we came back from the half. And I'm sorry that we had to come back from the mariachi band. That's really...
That mariachi band was awesome. That was so much fun. I hope that all you guys at home got to at least see a little bit of part of it. But if you didn't, you should be here.
So
just come on down.
Not so fun. Penalties.
Oh, my goodness. So Charm City, a little bit of penalty trouble. Kamikaze Cash. She was the lowest scoring jammer on the Charm City side and picked up six penalties doing it. Free Radical is at three penalties. Dottie Deathwish, Scariot Tubman, and Allie B. Back are all at two penalties on the Charm side. Rocky Mountain, this is the cleanest game I have ever seen them skate. Assault and Peppa is the only one with two penalties. Everybody else.
You mean Assaultin?
Assaultin?
Peppa.
According to Ringster, Assaultin? Peppa has two penalties. Everybody else has zero or one. It is insane. On the jammer scoring side, Rocky Mountain has Sweet Mary Payne with 60, Phantom Menace with 41, Susie Powell with 28, and Sharon Tacos with 23 points. Dottie Deathwish is the high scorer on the charm side with 17, Holly Go Hardly at 15. And we are back in the action, starting off with a power jam advantage for Rocky Mountain.
That is Sweet Mary Payne. She is lead jammer and high scorer for Rocky Mountain. She-Bear in the penalty box is standing. She is the transfer from Boston. And coming up to the front of the pack, nice recovery there at the front from Charm City. There is going to be a little break apart there, though. They are forced to let her go. That's a 5-point pass for Sweet Mary Payne.
She-Bear back on the track, does the star pass to Cherrylicious with a big grin on her face. Look at her go. She's like, yep, I'm jamming.
So really quickly, we do have I.M. Payne is injured. Nuck and Futz is
on the nine-month derby injury.
And, of course, they lost Susie Powell to Rocky Mountain. So some devastating blows, and people have asked about blockers on Twitter. But I really think the story is how the team is trying to compensate for this jammer issue.
I definitely think that is the case as well. 37 points for Charm City, 193 for Rocky Mountain. Phantom Menace up against Dottie Deathwish, who gets out and gets lead for Charm City.
That is Phantom Menace, who is working the front of the pack. Now a 3-1 formation, And she is through to, for her initial pass, I should say, lead jammer still, Dottie Deathwish, who is getting the call of call it from her bench. And that's going to be 3 points for Dottie. And Zadork says, no, I'm sorry. You did not get any points, Phantom Menace.
Sorry. Phantom Menace is like, really? You sure? All right, fine. Charm City at 40 points to Rocky Mountain's 193. 28 minutes left in this game.
Holly Gohardley, number 415, on the Fast Girl start line for Charm City, and Susie Powell, number 55, for Rocky Mountain.
I saw that Holly looked like she was angling to hit Susie Powell out. Did not work for her. Susie Powell trying to squeeze her way past that front grouping of Charm. Cherrylicious goes back to, oh, she thought she hit Susie Powell out.
Lead jammer status going to Holly Gohardley. So this is two in a row for Charm City.
Exactly what they needed. Susie Powell still working on her initial pass. Holly Gohardley.
Holly breaks through that box like a box cutter, says all 4 points, rip. And now she gets 5 with that jammer lap point. Susie had stashed the star in her wrist guard, it looked like, and now is recovering it, 4 point scoring. Holly gets knocked to the ground and calls it for one. Susie Powell looked extremely upset that she didn't get any.
And I bet she's upset. This is the first jam she hasn't gotten lead in this game so far, Susie Powell. Charm City, 47. 193 for Rocky Mountain, 26 minutes, 47 seconds left in this game. Roll faster and farther with Quick Ceramic Bearings. They're part of the Rydell family, so you can check them out on the internet.
Dottie Deathwish on the Fast Girl start line for Charm City against Sharon Tacos for Rocky Mountain. Sharon Tacos at the back, and that's going to be a multiplayer call being assessed to Dottie Deathwish. She's shaking her head on the way to the penalty box. Through for not lead jammer status is going to be number 33, Sharon Tacos, who did remove the star, and so she is coming in on her scoring run. And she's got a nice four box. She's breaking it apart with her hips, though, and pushes her shoulder forward to open the rest of the pack.
The Rocky Jammers have been really good about just powering through those charm walls. Like, yeah, well, I don't need fancy footwork. I just need to be steady on my line through the pack.
And really nice work in the mix for Tootsie Roller, just kind of breaking that wall apart, but coming out of the penalty box and grabbing a cutting the track penalty right out of the box. Going back to the box, that's Dottie Deathwish.
This is her fourth penalty in this game.
Rocky Mountain now at 203, Charm City 46. Trying to stem the bleeding here a bit is Charm City's blockers, and that is going to be a 5-point pass for Sharon Tacos.
Sharon Tacos new to the roster on Rocky Mountain this year and turning out to be a very formidable jammer. Well on her way to being a formidable jammer.
Nice bit of offense here in the middle of the pack from Bob Blah Blah. And at the back, finally back in Dottie Deathwish. Both of these jammers making their way through. That is an initial pass for Dottie Deathwish. Coming on a further scoring run, trying to be taken out on the inside by Colleen Best, who was unable to make that happen, and 5 more points for Rocky Mountain.
Rocky Mountain breaking the two-century mark, 213 points to Charm City's 46, 24 minutes, 24 seconds left in this game. And let's see, I will tell you about the WFTDA recognized tournaments program. It supports high quality tournaments hosted by WFTDA members worldwide. Applications for the recognized tournament program are open until September 30th. If your league is hosting a tournament this year, learn more about this program and apply at WFTDA.com/events.
Both jammers taken down. That is Gigi Hardy jamming for Charm City against Wild E Coyote. Penalty being assessed, a low block to Rocky Mountain. This is a power jam for Charm City.
This is the first time that Gigi Hardy is jamming in this game.
You know, it looks like one of those situations where Charm is saying, you have no penalties, GG Hardy. You will jam. And it's working. It was working for them. And now there is a cutting the track penalty being assessed to GG Hardy. So two jammer penalties in a row, one for Rocky, one for Charm. Coming back in action is Wildy Coyote.
And Cherry Licious also, she's the pivot, picking up a penalty as well. So having both of them sent in the penalty box, no bueno for Charm City. But Wildy Coyote says, I'm fine with that. I'll get through on my initial pass and come in and score some points.
Getting forced to the outside. Wildy Coyote able to maintain her footing on the inside for five more points for Rocky Mountain, bringing this to 218, Charm City 46.
GG Hardy out of the penalty box, setting up behind the pack. Getting an assist from Cherry Licious as she hits that backpack of Rocky blockers.
Really solid partner work here, though, from Charm City. And actually, I should say a three brace now. At the front of that brace is Hitzberg. Solid job maintaining contact with that jammer. And that is also Loretta Scars working on that. Great work keeping in front of the jammer, keeping hips up.
Very nice recycling.
And nice little hit out by Free Radical. They're not gonna make this easy for her. And sweeping her back to the inside, Hitzberg. And that was a full 5 points she was able to grab.
That bumps up Rocky Mountain score to 223 to Charm City's 46. Just under 22 minutes left in the game. WFTDA wants to say thank you to Derby Central for covering all of the tournaments, playoffs, and champs for this year. Check them out, derbycentral.com.
Holly Gohardley back on the line for Charm City. Coming up against Sweet Mary Payne for Rocky Mountain. Sweet Mary Payne now sitting on 69 points in this game of Rocky Mountain's 223. Getting pulled all the way back is Holly Gohardley. There's a call against Fiona Grapple, sending her to the penalty box through the outside, looking to get past one. Holly Gohardley is the jammer for Charm City. And you know, 40-ounce bounce on Twitter says Believance has struck, and maybe what Charm City needs is Believance.
Sweet Mary Payne trying to tiptoe her way along the inside line to get around Charm's defense. She finally manages to do that as they bridge out on the apex between turns 3 and 4.
Just trying to pry Rocky Mountain's wall open. Holly Gohardley says, your priority right now is to get me points. And they did, but two also grabbed from Rocky Mountain. So Charm City now 49, Rocky Mountain 225.
WFTDA also wants to give a shout out to Sugar Skull Designs. Thanks, you guys. You're awesome.
You are awesome.
And hey, let's do a Paladome break just for the heck of it. Tuna Nut.
That was easy. Just like that. And just like that, Dottie Deathwish recycled all the way back as she jams for Charm City, and Phantom Menace, lead jammer for Rocky. Dottie Deathwish working the front of the pack, gets a forearm penalty and is going to be going to the penalty box. 5 point pass and a power jam now for Phantom Menace. Jumping the apex lands it, and all 5 points just like that.
Charm City moves their four wall a little bit back away from the apex so we don't get a repeat of that easy scoring pass. Menace using number 99, make you pay as an assist and a ballast, as it were. She gets pushed out on the outside straightaway.
And working on the side to try to grab some points. Phantom Menace decides she's had enough. That's 4 points, though. She was able to grab all of them.
Dottie Deathwish is standing in the Derby Supply penalty box. So I guess Rocky decided, you know what? We've been doing so well with Susie Powell on the power jam starts. We're just going to do that again for another power jam start as Rocky Mountain sits on 239 points to Charm City's 49 with 18 minutes, 52 seconds left in this game.
And Dottie Deathwish also with 5 penalties as she stands. Susie Powell, number 5'5", jamming for Rocky Mountain. She comes against that box in front. Fiona Grapple trying to play a little bit of offense for her, breaking up that box. And she's able to do so long enough to get Susie Powell out on the outside. And she laughs, leaving skaters in her wake. And jumps the apex, grabs all 4 points there. The opposing jammer is in front of her. That's Dottie Deathwish out of the penalty box. And Susie Powell calls it.
Just as both jammers were hitting the back of the pack. Very sneaky. Sneaky Susie. Rocky Mountain with 243 points to Charm City's 49, 18 minutes left in the game.
Do you have believe-ins? Contact us on Twitter using the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA, or maybe you believe that believe-ins doesn't exist. Either way, we want to know.
On the Fast Girls start line, we have Sharon Tacos versus She-Bear. She-Bear trying to take that inside line. Sharon Tacos getting caught up in the back.
And there's a multiplayer call being assessed that's going to go to Free Radical. This is Free Radical's fourth penalty. There's a cutting the track penalty now going to Sharon Tacos. This is a power jam for She-Bear. She-Bear really trying to work her way past two. That's Bones Patrol, the pivot, giving her some grief. And she is going to get a penalty for a block. That is a block with the head penalty she's going to the box for.
Whoops, she has such fun footwork, and unfortunately she uses the opposite end of her body to try and block her way through. You can't do that.
Absolutely not. 49 Sharon. Points for Charm City.
Sharon Tacos back on the track, trying to get around Cherry Licious as last line of defense as Charm City's wall fell, literally, for a second there, resetting again in front of her.
Free Radical joining Cherry Licious at the front, trying to do some blocking. It's working. Nice partner blocking there. And Cherry Licious taking her to the inside, but she's right back out.
Charm City doing a nice job shutting the door, literally, on Sharon Tacos, making it as difficult as possible for her to get through. She-Bear back on the track, going back to the penalty box for a forearm call.
So that is going to make the fifth for She-Bear as well in the Derby Supply penalty box. Full four wall, though, for Charm City, getting mutilated there by Rocky Mountain. And that is another 5-point pass.
Wow. Rocky Mountain just having the pack at a standstill, opening it up on each side as Sharon Tacos hits that front charmed wall. She gets through. Oh, no.
There is a cutting the track penalty being assessed at the very end of the jam to Sharon Tacos. Sharon Tacos now with 3 penalties, I believe.
Interesting. And She-Bear was sprung from the Derby Supply penalty box right at the end of that jam as that penalty was being committed by Sharon Tacos. We see Dave Wood, the coach for Rocky Mountain, coming out. I bet he's going to challenge that call.
Yeah, that's an excellent time to do so. Rocky Mountain 251, Charm City 49, and we are going to have a team timeout from Rocky Mountain. We'll see if it turns into a review.
And while we are talking about that, we can talk about Rydell Skates, handcrafting quality roller skates for 70 years. Check them out online at rydellskates.com. Also, WFTDA wants to give a shout out again to Sin City for being the skate techs here for the Tucson tournament. I saw Trish the Dish sitting in the Sin City skates area, and she has her heckle signs. Thank goodness, all is right in my world. Always fabulous.
So Miss Moxie, our friend on Twitter, says, what is believance really? Well, you know, believance that you can score some points.
Do you have to sing Cher when you do that?
No.
Okay.
No. This term was, in fact, introduced by junior roller derby announcer Catman at the East Coast Derby Extravaganza. And so believance is really what he's talking about there is the mental game, right? So Charm City coming in not favored to win this game. Really, how do you prepare for a game that you're not entirely sure you can win? Really? It's a legitimate question that I think between Division II and Division I playoffs, we've seen a lot. And it's something extremely important, the positive mental outlook of these teams going into these tournaments and trying to turn that around to a win.
Holly Gohardley jamming for Charm City.
And is able to get lead jammer status.
Fiona Grapple thought she was going to try and get her. Nope, she was out of play. Holly Gohardley already around, already on her first scoring pass, going up against the Salt and Peppa at the head of that pack.
Right through the inside, Holly laughing for 5 points. She is now at 29 points for Charm City of their 54 points. Rocky Mountain at 251.
Sharon Tacos back on the track, does a fantastic apex jump, makes it. Oh no, she gets a back block.
She is going to go to.
Oh, no, sorry, it's a track. Sorry, there's multiple penalties going on.
Yes.
Trying to catch all of the ref signals has been interesting. Dave Wood is losing his mind on the sidelines. This is entertaining to watch him.
He is not happy with the what he considers to be the lack of calls in this game. Holly Gohardley is making her way through this pack. Nice work here. Colleen Best performing a little bit of offense. This is the offense that we did see last year out of Charm City in Salt Lake City, that sort of person-on-person defense and offense where they're coming in and they're opening up holes.
And again, when you have an experienced jammer, that works really well. You can go in, open it up, go back to your defensive wall and make things happen. Coincidence? No, it's not. Charm City with 61 points, Rocky Mountain 251, 13 minutes, 30 seconds left in this game. Hey, Bay Area Derby girls, thank you for being awesome with the WFTDA. You're so great, and it's so great to see you skate here in Tucson this weekend.
And there is going to be an official review from Rocky Mountain on that last one. So this is a perfect opportunity for us to thank more of our partners.
Especially people like Powerdyne, Cutting Edge Designs, Cutting Edge Performance. Thank you for supporting the WFTDA Powerdyne. And Quick Bearings. When you want quality, you think Quick.
Excellent. All right, so going back to Twitter. Hashtag talk to WFTDA is where we are. You're going to want to join us for the conversation.
Requested an official review on a no call on a cut in turn one on the Charm City Jammer.
I think that may have been the aforementioned losing his mind that you were referring to, Tara.
Yes, I think so.
All right.
I was hearing something that sounded like Gibbons from the fans, from the other skaters. I don't know what that was about.
There are quite a few Rocky Mountain fans in the vicinity right now, and they are very vocal, which is exciting. But we also have a number of teams who are finally sitting down to watch the rest of this game who have competed today, and that's very exciting.
I want to mention that next week we have another playoff tournament in Dallas, marking its 10th year of pushing the sport's athleticism and competition to new heights. The International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships bring together. Oh, are we about to hear something? Still. Oh, okay. Cirrhosis is saying, can I talk now? I'm going to finish this off. Playoffs and Championships bring together most talented skaters and teams in the WFTDA. Join us next week.
After review on the floor, the Charm City Jammer was on the tape, not over it. Therefore, she made an inbounds position. The no call on the floor will stand. Rocky Mountain does not retain their official review.
There you go.
Well, alrighty then.
Okay.
So everyone lost their mind and called for the official review.
And a review.
And it was for not on the Rocky Mountain side. But 251 points to Charm City's 62. I think they'll be okay.
Dottie Deathwish on the line for Charm City. She is sitting on 5 penalties.
Very interesting. Rocky Mountain trying to line it up against the Fast Girl Skates start line. Charm City lined up right ahead of them.
Sharon Tacos in the penalty box right through the inside. Dottie Deathwish, lead jammer, and coming back onto the track pretty much immediately, Sharon Tacos comes through and she passes the star to triple shot Misto. And trying to score points now, Dottie hurls herself at a three wall in the back, Charm City defending with a brace. And there's going to be a penalty assessed to Sharon Tacos again.
And Gagan on her way to the Derby Supply penalty box.
Nice apex hop from Dottie Deathwish. Four more points for Charm City. And triple shot Misto still working on the points. Charm City hemorrhaging blockers right now. Only one on the track. Only two for Rocky Mountain. Now it's 2-on-2. Coming through, Dottie just keeps scoring points.
Is a much needed jam for Charm City. They are now up to 80 points against Rocky Mountain's 251.
Another apex hop on the inside for four more points. Dottie is lead. She's gonna play the long game here. Triple shot Misto comes into the back, around the side. Beautiful pirouette for another 4 points for each of these skaters. That's a 5-point pass for Dottie.
And triple shot Misto looked like she was pushing against Cherry Licious as she made her way through on that pass.
Dottie tried to toe stop it around the side. Cherry Licious tried to take out triple shot Misto, failed. Hit to the inside from Bones Patrol. Action pack jam, Tara Armoff.
It certainly was a great jam for Charm City. They're now up to 89 points against Rocky Mountain's 263. 11 minutes, 29 seconds left in this game.
So Moxie asked what Believance looked like.
I think that jam.
I think that was what Believance looked like. There you go.
Believance in action right here on WFTDA-TV.
Number 308, Gigi Hardy jamming for Charm City. She's taking the front. Wildy Coyote jamming for Rocky Mountain, pushing the back wall of defenders here from Charm City. And getting forced out, recycled back onto the track quickly.
Gigi Hardy cannot get around that back three wall of Rocky Mountain. She's trying to get within Free Radical's range because she is the pivot.
And out to become lead jammer, Wildy Coyote. Behind her about a third of a track is Gigi Hardy. Coming in quickly to that Charm City wall, she breaks it apart. Almost sneaking a point at the back is Gigi, but that's 2-3 more points for Rocky Mountain. And that makes it 266 to Charm City's 89. 40-ounce bounce on Twitter says Dottie and her jam ref jumping the apex. Yes. Ten minutes left in this game.
Let's have another palindrome break. Brought to you by Radar Cigar. Toss it in a can. It is so tragic.
And there is going to be a penalty assessed, a forearm to Holly Go Hardly. She is jamming for Charm City, going to the box. Sweet Mary Payne, M80, is lead for Rocky Mountain. She is angling to get through on a scoring run. Cherry Licious says, not unless you get past me, and she does for 5 points.
Charm City setting up their four wall right there in turn two. Sweet Mary Payne able to juke to the side, break them apart, jukes to the inside, picks up 5 more points.
Rocky Mountain's hitters have been so effective on the offense here. Creeping forward is Gagan to help her jammer out. Oh, taking a nasty spill in front of the pack. Sweet Mary Payne is back up in action.
Holly Go Hardly back in the pack. Hands off the jammer star to the wrong person. Has to hand it back. Has to have to make this legal.
You don't want
to
pick it up. Yeah. No, you take it.
Oh, wait, you can't. Gimme.
That is Sweet Mary Payne for 4 points. Coming around again. Holly Go Hardly getting drawn all the way back. It looked like Sweet Mary Payne was taking a quick look at her to see where she was. Wasn't sure if she was in scoring position. And working on that front two wall. Cherry Licious and Colleen Best They're forced to let her go.
They're shoving each other into Sweet Mary Payne, and it doesn't even faze her.
And Holly Gohardly, still with the helmet cover in her hand, looks over at her bench and trying to do the best job she can of getting through the pack. And she stumbles through as the jam is called. Rocky Mountain doesn't
pick up any points on that. Rocky Mountain bumping themselves up to 294 points to Charm City's 89, 7 minutes, 45 seconds left in the game. Made in the USA, made for Derby, Rydell Skates, rydellskates.com.
We're getting ready for a full 5-on-5 here. Dottie Deathwish, number 514, taking on Phantom Menace, number 22 from Rocky Mountain. Pushing to the front, around the outside, Dottie Deathwish on her toe stops to become lead jammer.
And she is back to being lead scorer for Charm City in this game as well.
Ooh, jumping the apex, but hits the back. And is actually going to, that's a penalty that's going to be incurred here from Rocky Mountain's Tootsie Roller.
Charm City sitting on 18 penalties to Rocky's 10.
Around on the inside, nice pirouette for 5 points for Charm City. Phantom Menace still trying to work her way through. If she can get past the front defender.
She powers through. That's another scoring round for Rocky.
So Dottie sees the drawback and says, I'm not ready to deal with this. I'm going to call off the jam. She says, I did enough.
Are we done here?
56 points.
We're done here. Okay.
Rocky Mountain 298, Charm City 98.
6 minutes, 17 seconds left in the game. If you're tweeting about the playoffs, don't forget the hashtag WFTDA playoffs, and also hashtag talk number two WFTDA. And you can get all the scores, recaps, brackets, and more at WFTDA Tournament Central, WFTDA.com/tournaments.
Big pileup in the middle of the track as out for lead jammer, number 55, Susie Powell, right behind her, She Bear, number 2873 from Charm City. Charm lining up to play some defense at the front, gets completely discombobulated by Rocky Mountain. She Bear able to get her hips past all of them. Both of these jammers threw for 4 points, and Rocky Mountain's bench is telling Susie to play the long game.
And it was interesting how fast the pack was going on the first part of this jam. Now they are stopped in turn 2. Susie Powell coming up against great resistance.
And she's going to get a back block call going to the Derby Supply penalty box. This is now a power jam for Charm City.
She Bear gets through. That is 5 points for Charm City. Charm holding on to the middle. They've broken apart the Rocky pack. She Bear comes along on the outside, does a pirouette. That's 5 points for Charm City.
She Bear looks exhausted, but her footwork tells a different story, Tara Armoff. She's able to make this work. She's getting forced to the inside, but she's back on that track.
Rocky reforming their front wall, stalling She Bear on the outside.
Sweeping She Bear to the outside is Gagan, and she's back on the track, facing this 3 brace here.
And on the outside, Susie Powell back on the track, totally unnoticed by Charm City.
I think everybody was so excited that there were points being scored.
I know I was.
Susie Powell comes around the outside, makes a lap. That's 5 points.
And it looks like that her presence on the track has discombobulated Charm City there for a second. Now they're trying to split their time, back to splitting their time between offense and defense, and not working.
That is
for
another
them.
Back block being assessed to Susie Powell, and she just looks absolutely, what's the word I'm looking for? Flabbergasted? Disappointed. Disappointed, that's the word I'm looking for. She looks disappointed.
She can't be too disappointed with the score, though. Rocky Mountain, 311 points to Charm City's 116, 3 minutes, 36 seconds left in the game. Holly Gohardly on the Fast Girl Skates start line.
So there's a timeout by Rocky Mountain. They will have one more after this.
And you can follow at WFTDA Live for live tweets of WFTDA playoffs and championships. So I'm sure you guys want to talk to us. So again, use hashtag #talk2WFTDA to tell us things and more things about Believance and all that fun stuff. And actually, we have not seen anything about the hashtag pets of WFTDA so far.
Well, nope. We have had a few pet photos, although not using the hashtag, Tara.
So
you're right. Like, how are we supposed to find this if you're not using the hashtag, folks?
Just saying, folks.
Mm-hmm.
And also, you can follow the behind-the-scenes action on Instagram. Search WFTDA, and you'll find them. And they've been posting photos and little movie clips to Instagram. It's been very cool to follow that as well.
And Bam Bam would like to know if Mr. Pistol goes through 100 packs of gum per tournament. I'm starting to think so.
I'm betting that he's going through 100 packs of gum just in this game, the way it's going. A little bit nerve-wracking. Holly Go Hardly back at it, hitting that back wall of Rocky.
So there is that offense causing some holes for their jammer, but that's going to be a cutting penalty for Holly Go Hardly. This is going to be her third penalty of the game, but it is going to free Susie Powell from the penalty box. And she is back.
Facing that back wall of Charm. She squeaks by on the inside, taking the friendly side, as it were. Charm resetting in front of her. But she does make it through. She gets through as late jammer.
And coming around on a scoring run. Now Holly Go Hardly back on the track. So both jammers in action.
Susie Powell getting a push assist from Salt and Peppa. She keeps trying to take that inside line, and Charm is saying, no, not so much.
This is our inside line. A little bit of offense at the back from Holly Go Hardly.
Holly Go Hardly has taken the jammer cover off.
And she's handed it to Free Radical, who is now putting it on. And Susie Powell calls it. That's a 4-point pass for her. Rocky Mountain now 3-4-15, and Charm City 1-16.
2 minutes left in this game.
Now we are seeing the photos that you require, Tara Armoff.
Look at that. Oh, my goodness.
Cats of WFTDA from Regan Amon. Just for the announcers, thank you so much.
Look at the cute kitty cats. Wildly Coyote jamming for Rocky Mountain up against Dottie Deathwish for Charm City. Wildly Coyote trying to squeak by on the outside line. Oh, almost makes it. Bumps herself out.
Dottie Deathwish is lead, but she was forced to the inside, so she's going to be drawn all the way back. And she is able to make it through on the outside, on her toe stops, getting recycled. This is Wild E Coyote going to the penalty box, though, so it is now a power jam for Charm. Dottie keeps trying to hop through the inside on her toe stops and finally succeeds. She is a lead.
She succeeds with a little help from her friends on that. Charm City lining it up on the inside. Rocky walling it up in a four-wall box in the front.
And there's going to be a forearm penalty assessed. That is going to be one of Rocky Mountain's blockers.
That's make you pay.
Mm-hmm.
This is her third trip to the Derby Supply penalty box.
And that's a 5-point pass for Dottie Deathwish. Right out of the penalty box, Wildy Coyote.
Charm City swarming around her in the front, holding her back in their box formation. Dottie Deathwish getting hit out on the outside, getting recycled to the back herself.
So that nice box up at the front from Charm City, holding back Wildy Coyote. She was laughing for a moment there. That's going to be 4 points for Charm. And there is going to be a timeout taken, and it's going to be from Charm City. They would like to see one more jam in this game.
That one last jam, because there are 3 seconds on the period clock. Rocky Mountain at 315 points to Charm City's 125. And so we want to remind everyone, this is the last game of today. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow at 10 a.m. local time, we are going to see one of the consolation games. It is going to be Arizona Roller Derby up against Team United.
Tomorrow is another day. That's what they say, right? That was my poor Scarlett O'Hara.
Poor Scarlett O'Hara.
Poor Vivian Leigh accent. Tomorrow is another day. And for both of these teams, it will mean very different things. Charm City will move on to the next game that they are going to play is tomorrow morning against Tri-City. Rocky Mountain moving on to play VRDL.
Oh my,
yes.
That's going to be a fun one.
So the timeout is coming to a conclusion. Rocky Mountain 316, Charm City 125.
Sweet Mary Payne versus Holly Go Hardly. Oh, Holly Go Hardly going down in the middle of the pack. Sweet Mary Payne also going down, but resetting quickly, juking and jiving her way. She has one to beat on the inside line. She gets recycled to the back.
Holly Go Hardly going to the penalty box, and that's a multiplayer call sending her there. So this is a power jam now for Rocky Mountain.
Sweet Mary Payne coming up against that front wall of Charm. Nice assisting by the Rocky players.
Beautiful box here. She hits Free Radical. Free Radical says you shall not pass on the outside, but through on the inside. Sweet Mary Payne grabs five more points for Rocky Mountain.
Rocky Mountain thought they would grab a goat, then decide, nah, we don't need to do that. Let Sweet Mary Payne just hit that wall and see what she does with it.
She pushes forward is what she does. That box holds. Raven Darkhold falls to the ground and rejoins her teammates. The pack manages to hang together, though. Out of the box is Holly Go Hardly, and she is trying to push forward. There we have it.
Wow, the unofficial final. Charm City 125, Rocky Mountain 324.
40-ounce bounce on Twitter says, gotta give Charm credit. They never gave up. I never would have pegged this score from the first few minutes. Rocky Mountain 324, Charm 125, again, unofficial. So where are these teams headed tomorrow again, Sarah Armoff? Let's talk about that.
They are, okay, Rocky Mountain, they're going to be facing Victoria at 8 p.m. tomorrow evening.
The big show.
Yes.
And then this is game six, so the non-winner of game six is Charm City, and they will be facing off against Tri-City tomorrow, and they have the 12 p.m. game. And again, we did have some, how shall I phrase it? Some time zone challenges this morning, because even though if you line it up on latitude and longitude, we do fall within the mountain time zone. We are in the Pacific. We are 3 hours back. So we changed a few things. So you may want to use the magic time zone converter if you want to know where Arizona falls in relation to your time zone.
And Arizona is always on daylight savings time. So that's something to remember too in your funky calculations trying to figure out what time you should be waking up to watch all of this fantastic derby action on WFTDA TV. And we have a few stats. Lead jammer, Rocky picked it up 10 times in this half as opposed to Charm's 7. Penalty count, Rocky, again, really nice,
clean
game overall. 16 penalties to Charm's 22. And power jams, there were a few. We just couldn't keep track of all of them.
There were many.
We are waiting for our post-interview session with Derby Nerd.
Yes, and so he is going to have a conversation with a skater or two, and before we are able to talk about that, tomorrow is going to be really fun. It is going to start out at 10 a.m. Arizona time. It's going to be AZRD taking on Team United, and then followed by Tri-City, Charm City, and then we're going to move on to the Bay Area arch rival game at 2 p.m. So that's going to be a lot of fun. And then Terminal City at 4 o'clock will take on the winner of AZRD Team United. And then we shall move on to the 6 o'clock game on Saturday, which is Mad Rollin' Dolls versus the winner of Tri-City Charm City. And, of course, the big shoe is going to be VRDL versus Rocky. So it does look like Derby Nerd has some things to say to us. I'm Double H here with Tara Armoff. And we have had an awesome time. We're going to throw it down to Derby Nerd for an interview with a Rocky Mountain skater.
They must be closing things up, too. Thank you very much, Tara Armoff and Double H. I am now here trackside with Triple Shot Misto. What an impressive performance. But before we talk about that, I wanted just to talk about Rocky Mountain coming into this game.
Sure.
Now you guys had an interesting season, suffered some pretty heavy losses near the end of the summer, four in a row, all by about 100 or so points, which sounds kind of bad until you look at the teams you're playing.
Exactly.
Texas, London,
yes.
Denver, Angel.
Gotham.
Yes. So was this something that you guys had planned? Do you want to give yourself the hardest test you could coming into the playoffs this year?
Yeah, absolutely. We knew we had a tough schedule going into the season, and we just wanted to go up against the best. You can't get better practice than skating against the best teams out there. So at least we knew, like, hey, this is the top of the top. This is how we skated against them. We try and learn from those games, glean what we can, come together, improve. And so I think that really helped to, as much as it was hard to have all those disappointing losses, it really helped us come together as a team and learn what we could improve upon.
Yes, well, this was, I have to say, kind of a statement-making game, I think, for Rocky Mountain. I think every Derby fan remembers your showdown with Charm last year in Salt Lake City in that third-place game, about a 30-point finish. Much different today. Is this a matter of Rocky just stepping it up to another level? Charm falling, a little bit of mix of both?
You know, Charm is a great team. They were still really hard for our jammers. Yeah. Our jammers at halftime were like, hey, this is not a testament to them or to them not being good at blocking. Their defense is amazing. It's really a testament to how our walls were performing. I think we really have pulled it together and kind of refined what we were working on last season. Charm is a great team. They're a great team. And, you know, we had Susie who just came over from Charm. So that probably was a little bit of a double-edged sword. You know, they know how she plays, but she knows how they play. And so I think it helped to kind of know what they were doing and what we
did. Did she have something to prove maybe against her old team?
She probably did. And I think that was, you know, a personal great game for her. But they're a hot team.
Yeah.
They really were.
Now, there was a point in the first half, I think, you guys were leading, but it still was anyone's kind of game, and you managed to draw three straight penalties against Kamikaze Cash. You were part of that. Those nice pop bats that you love to do. Do you think that was a turning point at that point? Did you guys know, hey, this is ours to win now?
I do think that if any time you can kind of get one of their top jammers a little demoralized and three penalties, that's definitely going to get a little edge in their head, affect their mental game. I mean, anybody that jams knows that jamming is so mental. So, yeah, absolutely. She had six penalties at the half and really couldn't jam anymore. So I think that was huge in being able to help us close that out and really get a point spread there.
Yeah. Now, looking forward, Final Four, that's great. That's where you want it to be.
Absolutely.
Victorian Roller Derby League coming up. What are your thoughts on this game? Have you guys thought about this at all? It's going to be a tough test.
It is absolutely going to be a tough test. Victorian is not one of the amazing teams that we've played this season.
Yeah.
We're looking forward to playing them. They have great walls, amazing walls. And, you know, we've tried to do our best to kind of study that and see what they do. And hopefully we'll really be able to stack up against that and play an equally strong defensive wall. We're looking forward to it. It's going to be hard. We're by no means going into it blind, and we're just going to give it our all.
Well, congratulations on a great performance tonight. Good luck tomorrow and through the rest of the tournament.
Thank you so much.
All right, well, that's actually a wrap here for day one of the 2015 International WFTDA Playoffs here live in Tucson, Arizona. It's been a heck of a day. A little bit of everything. We had some blowouts. We had some tight matches. But we do have a few things set for tomorrow. So tune in, be sure, 10 a.m. local time for our beginning of our two consolation quarterfinals. The first matchup will be AZRD taking on Team United. That'll be followed right away by Tri-City taking on Charm City. Again, those are both consolation quarterfinals. The other two matches we have set tomorrow are the actual semifinals, the Final Four. 2 p.m. will be the first matchup. You will see arch rival and Bay Area Derby girls in what should be a phenomenal matchup. Two teams hot coming into the playoffs this year. And then at 8 p.m., the game we just talked about, Rocky Mountain Roller Girls against Victorian Roller Derby League. That is going to be one that you will not want to miss. Yeah. So on behalf of the WFTDA and Tucson Roller Derby, and on behalf of the WFTDA.tv crew, I am the Derby Nerd. Thank you, Roller Derby fans, for tuning in. And be sure to tune in 10 a.m. tomorrow for the continuing playoffs.